Good morning to all. This is our first ever attempt in audiovisual classes, so I think it will be helpful to you. Now we all know the present situation. We can't go out of our houses, we can't attend school, can't attend tuition classes, everything. So being locked down as the situation is, we all are staying at home, so it's not possible. But at the same time, we can't stop our studies as well, so we have to continue it. So let's begin. If there is any problem, any queries after watching and listening to the video, you may contact me. I will try and help solve your queries. So the present topic we are going to discuss today, from English 2, one of the poems we have already in the syllabus, that is a poem by an African-American author, Maya Angelou. She is an African-American feminist author, writer of the black people in America. Now, before we go into the poem, before we go through the poem, we need to know about the situation, the background, a bit about the poet's life as well. Now, as we are saying African-Americans, we need to know the term very well. After America was discovered, the European settlers, they gradually moved off there and started to live there. They made a habitat, an actual living there, and there also they started taking people along with them. So when the European countries, they started establishing their colonies throughout the world, in the Asian countries, South Asian countries, in African countries, Latin American countries, in those colonized nations, people were treated as slaves, and the European settlers, they started to take those slaves along with them for their own benefits. So many African Negroes, many African black people, they were also taken there. So in America at the same time, there was not only the American original, the aboriginals, the red Indians, but at the same time there were African slaves. And there was hardly any difference between the lifestyle or the living of the African slaves as well as the red Indians. So basically, like the Red Indians, the Afro-Americans or the African-American slaves, they were also treated harshly. They were also the subjects of ethnic and racial discrimination, repression and deprivation. So here the poet, who is a representative of the Afro-American class, she is also delineating a picture of how the Afro-Americans or the African-American people, they are craving for freedom. Actually, all the African-Americans, they are not having the access to freedom. Freedom is denied to them, justice is denied to them. But still, there is a faint hope within them. Although they are fearful, although they are repressed under poverty, malnutrition, negligence, illiteracy, but still they are having a faint hope in their heart that someday they will be able to break away the chain of slavery. Now, as I have already mentioned, that Maya Angelou, she was born in 1928 and died in 2014, and to her credit, she also wrote an autobiography of the same name as we have in the poem, that is I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings. It's the name of the poem here in our syllabus, but the same name is also that of that particular autobiography she has written. And in that autobiography, Maya Angelou has recorded her own personal experiences from the age of 3 till the age of 17, which was really a traumatized or really traumatic experience for her. And the situation which started from when she had been of only 3 years of age, and ultimately ending at 17 when she had already become a mother by that time. So quite a horrible and terrific experience she had throughout her life, and a particular autobiography records that. And as a feminist author, we all know that the feminism is a social and a literary movement that became popular after the 1960s, and it was reflected both through literature and arts. Now, why feminism? Because we all are living in a male-dominated or androcentric, or what is better called a patriarchal society, where before the 1960s or in the past, the contribution of the women, it was not given proper acceptance. But with the wake of feminism, feminism was characterized by the acceptance, protection and establishment of women equality and women contribution in the society. So by the time Maya Angelou was writing, feminism or the spark of feminism was already there, and she was one of those advocates of feminist trends. Now that particular poem we are going to analyze, it was actually written by the poet in 1969 and it was published later on, a few years later, in 1983. The poem that is written in free verse, we need to know what is free verse. Free verse is, we have already learned blank verse while we were in class 7. Blank verse, Shakespeare and his contemporaries used to write his plays. Maybe that is, we have The Merchant of Venice written in blank verse. But free verse is, it is almost like a prose style. As if prose writings are written, free verse is also written in a prose style. It do not, actually doesn't have any metrical pattern, as well as there is no specific rhyming scheme. Again, I am repeating, a free verse is almost like a prose writing. It doesn't have any specific metrical pattern as well as any specific rhyming scheme. So written in free verse, that poem, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, that is totally divided into 6 stanzas. And in that particular poem, the poet has presented a contrast. Contrast between whom? Contrast between two birds. By presenting the contrast between two birds, one is a free bird and another one is a caged bird. By drawing that contrast between the free bird and the caged bird, the poet is trying to make people understand what the situation is, or how the people in the outside world, or how the people in the outer world, they are having justice, they are having their freedom, they are enjoying their liberty. And on the other hand, the caged bird that represents the African Americans, they are dying under their graves. They are, how much they are angry and how much they are craving for freedom. So that contrast serves, the entire poem is a symbolic poem, and the very bird, the word bird, is serves as a motif. Motif, what is motif? A motif is a recurrent image or a symbol or maybe an object which goes on occurring throughout the poem. If we read the poem, we will get the word bird. The bird is a general symbol or a general motif that is functioning throughout the poem. Sometimes it becomes a free bird, sometimes it becomes a caged bird. Now, the free bird, it's the symbol of freedom and liberty, delights, joys. And the caged bird, it's the symbol of slavery and imprisonment. So the poem actually bears out, of the poem actually presents the themes of social disparity in the contemporary American setup, as well as alongside social disparity, we have their freedom and justice. These are some of the consistent themes we have in the poem. And again, for our convenience, let me summarize the theme of the poem. The poem records the traumatic situation faced by the African Americans who were subjected to social disparity and prejudices. It portrays the theme of social disparity, freedom and justice. The caged bird is a potent symbol of all the African Americans craving and striving for freedom. While we have the free bird in the first stanza and the third stanza of the poem, the poet is talking about the free bird. The free bird is enjoying its freedom, and he claims the entire sky to be his own. He claims the entire universe to be, because he has delights of mind. There is nothing to be worried. There is no one to snatch his freedom from him. So he is the symbol of joy. He is the symbol of freedom and liberty, and he is enjoying his life. But unlike them, the African Americans, freedom is denied to them. They are neglected. They are totally deprived of freedom and liberty. They cannot even enjoy life in their own way. they actually live their life with fears in their eyes. Their dreams they are dreaming of every night, they are like nightmares, and as if their dreams are living under the graves. So, but still, those African Americans, they are a bit optimistic, they are a bit hopeful that maybe this is God's world, God is everywhere present. So maybe God will someday bring a change. Maybe a day will come which will be theirs. Maybe a day will come, their imprisonment will be broken, their captive state will be broken, and they will also achieve freedom. So that is a faint hope of optimism that also lies in the voice of the song, that also lies in the voice of the African Americans, who sings out of agony, who sings out of pain. Now, if we talk about the stanza basis, or the stanzas about the stanza analysis of the poem, the first stanza and the third stanza presents the viewpoint of the free bird, and the rest of the stanzas, mean the second stanzas and the fourth, fifth and sixth stanzas, presents the caged bird and his situation. Now the third stanza and the sixth stanza, we have already known what is refrain, that poetic device which is used in a poetry only to emphasize or only to enhance a particular idea or a particular notion. So here also the third stanza and the sixth stanza of the poem, they are refrains, they are exactly the same. Now before reading out the poem, I can just remember two other poems almost related to the same topic. One of our Henry Louis Vivian DiRozio, you all know Henry Louis Vivian DiRozio, the youngest teacher of the Presidency College, who became a teacher at the age of 17. He wrote a poem, Freedom to the Slave. There also DiRozio is explaining freedom to the slave, a slave. He knows what sort of life it is to live as a slave. The bond or the chain of slavery. How painful, how agonizing it is. Only a slave, only a person who is a slave, he knows that. Now, when freedom comes to him, when he wins freedom, that moment of joy or that sort of experience he has right at that moment when he is freed, when his chains are broken, that is also a unique one. So freedom to the slave, suppose a caged bird who has been within the cage, that has been within the cage for several days, and all of a sudden the bird is let off. Now when the bird first comes out of the cage and flies in the air, that joy, that moment of joy, it is really unique and incomparable. Another poem I want to tell you about Bengali poet Rabindranath Tagore, from Sanchayita, there is a poem, Boner Pakhi o Khachar Pakhi bole ekta kobita ache. Shekhaneo kintu the two birds, Boner Pakhi, that represents freedom and liberty, and Khachar Pakhi represents enchantment, imprisonment, captivity. Ekhaneo kintu duto pakhi, duto symbol. Some people who are enjoying their freedom and others who cannot, who are denied to it. Shekhaneo kintu two worlds, two different worlds are brought into a contrast. Boner Pakhi, he is describing his own state of joy, his own world, so full of joys without any worries. And Khachar Pakhi, he is also telling about the world he is accustomed to within the cage, because he is enclosed within the cage and he is separated, he is cut off from the outside world by the bars of the cage. So ekhaneo kintu sei eki dhoroner contrast, the same kind of contrast we have here, and the free bird is a representative of all the Americans, maybe the European Americans or the others who were privileged, and the caged bird is the symbols of the African American slaves, the black Americans, African American black Americans who are underprivileged, who do not have any access to freedom, who do not have any access to any social advantages. Rather, they are socially, economically, racially repressed and denied in every ways. So this much for the introduction. And you just tell me if you have any queries regarding the introduction. I will try to make it clear to you all. In the next video, we will discuss and analyze the poem, the text of the poem. So follow it up. Thank you.